New projects can be created from the home page, project menu, or the My Project area when you are signed in. To begin, sign in with your free NBS user account. You may already have an account if you use any of these other NBS services. If you do not, click on the Register for Free button at the bottom of this window. Fill in some information about your job, including a unique reference number, a title, and optionally a description of works where you can give a brief overview of the project. From here, there are four ways to create a new project. You can start a basic project with the Create Now button. This will create a project with pre-written tasks and roles for each work stage of the project. You build on this by adding the partner organisations and contributors who will be working on the project. As the project progresses, you can assign them tasks and deliverables for each work stage. Secondly, you can use a predefined template choosing from four options. There is a template based on the RIBA plan of work, another using the Construction Industry Council role terminology, one suitable for geographical infrastructure developed with the support of the Environment Agency, or one for linear infrastructure developed with the support of Highways England. They differ by the pre-written tasks and roles they contain. You can also base a new project on one of your existing projects. So, if you already have a project on your BIM Toolkit account which you want to reuse for another job, you can do this with this option. Tasks, roles, deliverables and participating organisations will be copied across, but individual contributors and comments will not. This is a useful option when you want to reuse what went well on a previous project. The last option is to browse to a template file exported from the BIM Toolkit. You can export projects you have set up. One of the files exported is a project template file, which has a file extension of .dpow. It will import the tasks, roles, deliverables and organisations from that project. So another user can use the .dpow file to import this into their BIM Toolkit. This is helpful if there is a change in project administrator, so you can import a DPOW file someone else has exported from their BIM toolkit and pick up where they left off. This may also be helpful if you work within a larger organisation and are trying to push consistency through your supply chain on every project. Exporting and importing are covered in more detail in separate videos and articles in the support area. After creating the project, you can add information such as a project image and postcode in the Edit Details page.